We're live on my-soul.com, live on the internet to you guys from Southport Soul Weekender. It's the it's the 50th edition. I think it's 25 years, but I might get that wrong. You probably know, Giles. Do you know how long it's been going? How many years?
Well, hello. How's it going, man?
Well, you've got a nice mic.
I've got a nice mic, nice and sparkly right now. I just saw you a few days ago. Yeah. And now I see you here.
Somewhere else.
In the wind. This has been going for a few years. Although I always kind of leave London thinking I should be going up the M1. Because, of course,
well,
Southport.
That's the original.
Southport, right?
It's called Southport.
And I was thinking, actually, today, I bet you there's a few people every year who go to Butlins or Pontins in Southport because they think they're going to blag it, and they get there and they go, there's nothing happening. I bet there's a few.
Wrong Pontins, bro.
A few Liverpudlians.
We're in Butlins now.
We're in Butlins now, yeah. With there's even a Burger King here.
And a Pizza Hut.
I'm
not sure if we're allowed to say that. Anyway.
It's great. It's amazing. And I just bumped into John Morales. The thing about these places and these, well, I mean, you know, this is a rare event. But for me, when I first sort of got into the music, 15 years old, 16 years old, I was taken to Caister Soul Weekender. I was one of three members of the Sutton Soul Patrol.
Deep.
We wanted to beat up. We wanted to compete with the Brixton Frontline because they were the most powerful, the most mighty collective of people who used to go to the Caister Soul Weekend.
And was that Southwark Soul Patrol?
No, I was the Sutton Soul Patrol.
Sutton.
Yeah, all three of us, yeah.
Versus the Brixton...
Brixton Frontline. Oh, the legendary Brixton Frontline. And the point being that it was a great place to be able to just kind of unite with all the people who had the same love of music. And it's a great place for us to meet, mix, hang out, meet the DJs, 4 days, get decadent if you want to. If you don't want to, enjoy it, meet people, fall in love, regret... dance to records that maybe you shouldn't do. Line dancing.
Line dancing?
Yeah. Oh, God, yeah.
I haven't seen that here.
Oh, it happens. I've seen it.
Yeah, man, never been here long enough.
You know, I need to check it out. I need to get deep into it.
Now, this is mighty. This is this is so incredible for all of us to be able to come here every year. For me, it's, you know, I've done them all. I've done, you know, Prestatin and... I don't know. Nicky Holloway used to put on these mad ones in Bognor Regis. You know, when Acid House first started. The whole period. And so Alex Lowe's, who's been putting this together for. I mean, it's a shame it's not twice a year anymore, right?
Yeah, no. The
Why?
They're going to do the.
What happened?
The Heritage one. Now.
Oh yeah, Heritage. There you go. It's time for Heritage. But as you were saying, there's people here from like the ages of sort of 18 to almost 80.
Yeah.
And it's also an incredible mixture of different sort of people here. You know, you get all races, cultures, people from all over the world. It's a really mixed crowd. And I think you get, like, especially in London, I think things are a little bit less mixed than they are when you come here. Because you get Birmingham, you get Manchester, you get obviously all of Scotland.
That's the amazing thing about it is, you know, not only do you get the international crowds, but you do get the Birminghams and the Manchesters and the Bristols and everyone coming together, which is quite rare.
Very rare.
For the UK, you know, it's usually very kind of local, or you know,
you
find a Manchester lot together, or the London.
Mancunians
lot
don't often come to London, do they? For a party, because
really
they have their best parties in, you know, in their own yard. But this is where we all come together.
That's how it comes together. Well, coming together, I mean, Kerry had Azimuth Jazz Carnival lined up as one of his tunes, so I thought it'd be a good time to get you guys together to share your. Love for Azimuth.
What his story is. I know what mine is, but I'm curious to hear his.
Well, what do you mean?
What are your memories of Azimuth?
Well, Azimuth, the funny thing is about Azimuth is that when that record came out, Jazz Carnival, it was a hit record in the UK.
Oh, yeah.
It was a hit record. It was in the top 20.
Really?
Yeah, that's in the days that these sort of records would sort of, you know, cross over. An instrumental record from a trio from Brazil. Because the jazz funk scene back then was so strong, so powerful. There was a big movement. You know, you had groups like Light of the World, groups like High Tension, Level 42, groups like Second Image, Incognito, who were here actually with Chaka Khan today, groups like Incognito, like Azimuth, you know, who just put out these crazy records that certain DJs like Chris Hill, Robbie Vincent, Steve Walsh, the pirate DJs. They had so much power in those days that they could actually get these records in the charts. So great record. Still sounds amazing today.
I just played it in the dorm. And everybody just went mental. I loved it. And this guy just jumped out of nowhere and started dancing. The artist just jumped up and started dancing like he's like breaking and everything. Yeah. So it was
and you played the original version? Yeah. No edits? No re-edits?
Original all the way through start.
Straight up. See, it's back to that, man. It ended.
I let it end. Like the proper way.
You know what? I might do the same thing tonight. Do you mind if I might bite you on that one?
There you go. You're getting DJ tips straight.
I haven't got it on my stick though.
I'm sure he played it way before I even heard of Azimuth. But
how did you hear about Azimuth?
Well, I just went, you know, crate digging as we do back in New York, and I bought every single album of theirs. But the thing that really got me was, I came to Southport and they were performing.
Yeah.
And I was just like, I could not believe this thing. And I stood on stage. I was like in tears. Like it was.
Yeah.
It just. And on top of it, I met them, and they asked me to remix something. And so to me, it was like my hair was like, what? You're kidding? What? Who, what? So I was shocked. It was like, to me, it was like a dream come true again.
Have you got the original 12-inch on Milestone Records? Yeah, there you go. Okay, I had a spare one. I was up for a swap.
DJ Dealing's going down. Right, let's get to it. We'll let this one fade out as well, I reckon. We'll be right back. I say Azimuth, but I think it's Azimuche, isn't it?
Oh, now we're getting a little bit.
Just trying to show off a little bit of knowledge.
A little bit, yeah. You know, it's funny, actually. What an ending as well.
You know, it's great.
It's
isn't
got
it?
The whole thing.
You can't, start, you can't actually.
Got the breaks. In fact, Kerry's currently pulling it out for me to play it later.
Oh, nice. Putting it on the USB.
One that's, of how runs. That's how it runs. That's how it runs. That's how unorganized I am. Just prove that I never sort out my certain
advance. Well, you went from trying to swap Rare Records to swapping MP3s.
Yeah. So that's what I assume it's a pretty chunky web he's going to give me as well.
Yeah, proper one.
Nothing off iTunes.
Sorry, let's hope. MP3, but
none of that 256 rubbish.
None of them things there. But as a Muche.
And unfortunately, I was saying, sadly, Roberto Bertrami, the keyboard player, he passed away last year. And Azimuth played in the Brownswood basement. We did a boiler room last year, last summer. It was amazing.
Yeah,
and
it was amazing.
They played that song and
cramped into the basement.
We had another one this week with Bad Bad Not Good, Nana Cherry a few weeks ago. We're going to do more of those, which is a lot of fun.
We've got a dedicated channel and everything, got a plan.
And Decadent Tuesdays.
Decadent Tuesdays. Why can't we come on Wednesdays when you've got the cheese out?
Yeah, maybe. Cheese Wednesdays.
Welcoming.
That could work. But the performances might not be up to it. Cheese might just, you know,
weigh them down a little bit.
A little bit.
Well, the rosé is good. Lines there.
Yeah.
Slightly.
You know, it was great to see Gordon Mack this morning as well. Well, listen to Gordon Mack on the radio this morning because he played a track off my new album.
Oh, indeed.
Which was a bit of a cheeky one. So it was really nice to hear him play Southern Freeze. I assume you're going to ask me about my record at this point.
Yeah, I'm getting there. I thought you were going to... It sounded like you were enjoying
just,
it yourself.
I'm just moving it along a bit.
That's fine,
I'm moving it along.
It means I can chill.
Yeah, yeah. But it's actually, we're continuing on the Brazilian thing because I went to Rio in January and made a record out there. And in a way, it would have been nice to work with Azimuth, but I didn't want to work with too many artists that were already working with Far Out, with Azimuth, with Joe. I don't
want
to...
That must be quite hard.
Yeah, because he's got most of them nailed. but yeah, so I didn't work with Joyce or Azimuth, but I did actually do a few songs with Marcos Valle and Serge Georges and a few other sort of legends. And the one song I was going to play for you was a track which because they've kind of changed it around a little bit this year at Minehead Southport. We've moved what was the beat bar from what is now the Connoisseur's Room, which was the outdoor bit. And they've put us inside now, and it's made it a bit smaller, which actually I think could take it a little bit more towards the experimental.
More intimacy.
A little bit less of a, you know, feeling of having to get 1,000+ people dancing.
Well, it's nicer when you can reach out and touch the crowd.
Yeah, and it reminds me a little bit more like the, you know, what was the beat bar back at the old Southport. So I think that's kind of nice. So I'm going to play a bit more, I reckon, jazz type stuff. Try and get the dancers back out.
Yeah, man.
Because that's always been one of the really nice things about coming here. There's always been a strong dancing tradition. So
you played the jazz dance on Sundays quite a bit, didn't you, back in the day?
Back in the day, yeah, we always. I mean, you know, the dancers would come here. I mean, before the weekenders, they used to be all-dayers in Leeds and Nottingham and all over the place where there'd be two rooms. There'd be the room sort of playing boogie and disco, early days of electro, and then there'd be another room where they'd be playing like 100 mile an hour hardcore Afro-Cuban, you know, fusion, bebop, the whole thing. That's actually where I first heard people like Art Blakey, you know, Night in Tunisia.
Deep.
You know, playing like Bob Jones at Kaster, playing it in the back room and thinking, this is the music for me. So it was a completely different environment to hear that kind of music to what, you know, was associated with that kind of music from back in the day. And I think that tradition has always sort of been quite a big part of British music culture, club culture. And in a way, it's died down a little bit. And I thought that here at Southport, before, there was always that sort of strong part of it was still alive. But since they moved us in the bigger room, I think we lost it a little bit because all the DJs ended up playing variations on house music, you know, and which is fine. But in a way, you just end up more or less at 128 BPM and it doesn't really vary that much. So the new room, I think, is going to allow us to get a little bit more deep again. We've got Zara McFarlane playing tonight in a moment, which I'm looking forward to. And after that, I'll be on and I'm going to play some, you know, I'll play a little bit of Fortet, obviously.
Yeah,
you know,
give a little
got to play the new Martin and Fortet record.
Oh, yeah, that is a serious track.
Got to play a little bit of DJ Rashad.
Of course.
But I can also play a little bit of 100 mile an hour sort of Brazilian, Latin, hardcore dance music.
Would you say playing at somewhere like Southport or the Case of Soul Weekend? I mean, you're heralded as one of the most eclectic DJs in the world. Would you say that influenced the way in which you select tracks and mix it up between genres and vibes and nationalities.
Well, I think that when you've been brought up here in the UK and you've been hearing people like Bob Jones or Paul Murphy playing, you know, crazy fusion from Poland in a back room to a bunch of dancers doing knee drops and break dancing to crazy music like that, then you can't fail but be influenced by it. I mean, that is an incredible part of British club culture legacy. You know, America's got Larry Levan and it's got all the things that we know all about. But over here, we got Northern Soul, we got the jazz dance scene. That is, you know, hugely important. And people took massive risks to play that music in that environment. So I think it's very important to keep that legacy alive and to keep flying the flag for that. And the next record, I think, kind of fits into it. So it kind of connects the project that I did in Brazil in January, which was Sonzera is the group that I put together. And we did a song called Jibaba, which was written by Aieto and Hermeto Pascoal. And it features a brilliant accordion player called Chico Chavas. Nice little breakdown. It's a proper one to dance if you're at home and you're listening to this right now. Turn it up.
Have a little bubble.
Have a little bubble and have a little dance to this one, Jibaba.
It's Boiler Room taking over My Soul Radio, live from the 50th edition of Southport Soul Weekend. We've got Charles Peterson and Kerry Chandler sitting with us. We've got Joe Negro and John Morales coming. I hope you're having a good time.